All right, thank you very much, Anna. Ready or not, retirement is going to happen for all of us someday. Nancy Coteau and John Gajkowski are with us, certified financial planners and founders of Money Managers Financial Group. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
And you've got important information for all of us. So I think one of the things a lot of people probably believe today, especially with the financial meltdown of the past several years, is I'm really never going to have to, I'm never going to be able to retire. Mm-hmm. I got to work forever. True or no? Nancy, what do you think?
Well, definitely things have changed since the year 2008. People have seen a rough time. People have, you know, experienced things that they've never experienced in the past. The key is that you have to start focusing on retirement. It's, you know, you're taken away by kids and education and bills and so forth. But if you don't focus on your retirement, there's not going to be anything there for you.
Right. And you really want to get a good jump on it early and plan, because what happens for a lot of people is a lot of money unnecessarily falls through the cracks. And if they plan, that money wouldn't be falling through the cracks and end up in their pockets.
But Nancy, don't you hear from everybody, my gosh, I can barely get food on the table and get my kids' expenses taken care of. How do I do it? So where do you start with someone with a really tight budget?
You really document it. The number one, the first thing we do is actually document what your real expenses are, because it's amazing how much money falls through the cracks. Mm-hmm. And you can really do it. There are some very creative ways to get an extra $50 or $100 or $500 out of that budget. But first you have to document what you're spending money on before you can find those dollars.
And John, you say too, it's very important to initially try to establish a rainy day fund.
Yeah, for everybody, it's kind of, you need to build the foundation. So what you should always have is 3 to 6 months of expenses readily available. And what we mean by that is you want to have a primary reserve, checking accounts, savings accounts, money markets that you can get your hands on immediately, and then a secondary reserve where you can access money. The real key is having an understanding where your money is at and what you need to do to get to it, and have a strategy just in case you ever need it.
Right. And, you know, just the idea of knowing your risk tolerance and investing appropriately. I mean, those are nice terms, but how do you really know what that means? I mean, you have to do some work here, don't you?
Okay, so definitely you have to do some work, because the key is everyone now is anxious to get in the market and they're trying to make up for lost time.
Right.
Since the year 2008. It's a very risky venture. You really have to start with, we use the rule of 100, which is 100 minus your age, so that if you're 25, 75, 35% of it can be at risk, but if you're 65, 35% of it should be at risk. At risk meaning it's fluctuating in value.
Sure.
And you have to understand and ask yourself, how much can I afford to lose? Because yes, the market's up right now, but who's to say it doesn't go down tomorrow? And who's to say when the next 2008 is? And when you're approaching retirement, it's absolutely crucial that you protect what you've already accumulated.
And John, then once you hit retirement age, then your strategy needs to be tweaked a little more, right?
Well, absolutely, because what you're doing is going from an accumulation stage to a decumulation stage. So what you really have to do is understand the strategy and realize that it's different. And the problem with most people is they don't make that change, and it can cost them in the long run.
Got it. Nancy, John, thanks for being here. Lots of ideas, and boy, my head's spinning, okay?
Thanks very much.
Great to see you. Thank you, Nancy, John. Appreciate you being here. Over to Mark.